Celebrating the Webb Space Telescope's first year of science, testing remote possibilities of a NASA humanoid robot, and a fleet of clean new rides for Artemis astronauts. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. On July 12th, we celebrated our James Webb Space Telescope's first year of science operations with the release of this new Webb image of the Rho Ophiuchi cloud complex, the closest star-forming region to us, some 390 light-years away. Since the release of Webb's first full-color images in July 2022, the telescope has discovered some of the earliest galaxies ever observed, delivered the most detailed views of atmospheres of planets outside our solar system, and captured new views of planets within our solar system. Learn more at nasa.gov/web. NASA and Western Australia's Woodside Energy plan to use a NASA Valkyrie robot to test robotic remote operations at the company's facilities. The collaboration could lead to improved operational safety and efficiency at the company's offshore and remote installations. The venture could also help NASA develop a remotely operated mobile robot capable of working in conditions not suited for humans, like those astronauts may encounter on future Artemis missions to the moon. On July 11th, three specially designed, fully electric, environmentally friendly crew transportation vehicles were delivered to our Kennedy Space Center by CANU Technologies Incorporated. The zero-emission vehicles will be used to transport astronauts from the crew quarters at Kennedy to their rocket and spacecraft at Launch Pad 39B ahead of Artemis missions to the moon. NASA Armstrong's DC-8 aircraft is conducting a series of low-altitude flights over some of the most densely populated places in North America as part of a collaborative effort with NOAA. The project is called AEROMA, short for Atmospheric Emissions and Reactions Observed from Megacities to Marine Areas. It looks at how urban emissions and atmospheric chemical reactions that stem from the use of everyday items like personal care products and cleaning agents affect air quality and climate. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.